Today we will be talking about how to use the Mesh Baker component. By combining meshes, we can increase performance by reducing our number of draw calls. We can see the number of draw calls happening in our scene in the frame debugger, the profiler, or the statistics window. Here is a quick example showing how to bake together multiple objects that already share the same material. In this simple scene, I have several stacks of dice prefabs. The different colored dice use different materials, so will have to be baked separately. To see how to combine objects with different materials, check out our video on the Texture Baker component. If we play this scene as is, the GPU is processing 489 batches. Let's start by combining just the red dice together with the Mesh Baker component. The easiest way to create one is by going to Game Object, Create Other, Mesh Baker, and selecting Mesh Baker from the dropdown. Take a look at the Mesh Baker component inside the inspector. Here in the Objects to be Combined section is where we will put our input meshes. We could drag each individual dice, or you can drag in the parent and Mesh Baker will crawl through and grab every child. You can see that they're in there by expanding this dropdown. Dragging renderers in like this doesn't scale well when it comes to large scenes. Thankfully, Mesh Baker includes tools for quickly adding objects to your bakers. Check the link in the description to learn more. Now let's click Bake with the default settings. You'll see that a new object appears in our scene hierarchy. This is the combined mesh we just baked. Right now, it's in the exact position of our source objects, but if you move it, you'll see it's an exact copy of the red dice. Now that the meshes are combined, the physics on each dice no longer works. We can fix this by baking our dice into a skinned mesh. Skinned meshes that have many vertices are expensive, but these dice are very low poly, so baking them together as a skinned mesh is a cheap way to reduce a bunch of draw calls to one. In the inspector, switch the Renderer field over to Skinned Mesh Renderer. Now each source game object will act as a bone for the skinned mesh. Don't forget to click Bake to rebake our combined mesh as a skinned mesh. Now that we have a combined mesh, we no longer need to render our original source objects. The button underneath Bake allows you to quickly disable the renderers on all its source objects. We leave the original game objects in the scene because they have colliders, scripts, and physics rigid bodies on them that are needed for the dice to interact with the game properly. If we play our scene again, our single combined mesh has already reduced our batches to 327. Let's bake the blue dice together using the same process and see what that does for our draw calls. We could bake all three stacks of blue dice into one combined mesh, but notice that only two of the stacks are visible to the main camera. It's good practice to only combine together meshes that are visible at the same time, so that objects outside of the camera's view can be culled. Mesh Baker provides a tool to help group objects together for baking. Check out our video on the Mesh Baker grouper. We'll manually bake these blue dice as two different groups. You could reuse the Mesh Baker already in our scene, but for simplicity I will add two more Mesh Bakers so each group has its own. Reusing a Mesh Baker for different source objects will be covered in the next Mesh Baker video, which explains all the settings in the inspector. We've gone from over 200 separate dice to 3 combined meshes using the Mesh Baker component, and our batches have dropped from 489 to 28. While that covers the basic usage of a Mesh Baker component, there's still one more feature I'd like to show off. Currently, the combined mesh is a game object in this scene, not an asset in the project. To use it in another scene, we need to convert the bake result to a prefab. All that requires is switching the output dropdown to Bake into Prefab. That will make a new field appear that holds the prefab you want to bake into. You can drag an existing prefab here, or just click Create Empty Prefab beside the field. I'll call mine Combined Red Dice. That creates the empty prefab in my project folder. After clicking Bake again, the combined mesh will also appear in the project folder, and will be used by the prefab we created. We can now reuse these combined meshes in any other scene. The combined mesh is an asset in the project folder in Unity's internal mesh format. It can't be opened using an external 3D modeling tool. To learn how to modify this mesh using a program like Blender, check out the video links in the description. If you're going to be baking very large meshes, you should also know about Unity's two mesh sizes. 16-bit meshes can hold up to 64,000 vertices, while 32-bit can hold up to 4 billion, at the cost of memory and speed. Mesh Baker automatically converts between the two, but for further control you can use our MultiMesh Baker, which has its own dedicated video. Links to all the tutorials mentioned in this video can be found in the description. Mesh Baker is available on the Unity Asset Store. You can also check out digitalopus.ca where you'll find more resources and tips for using Mesh Baker.